Hey there, this is Veeresh Halli and I would like to give a quick demonstration of a web application called Restaurant. Restaurant is a web application built using Django as backend web framework, HTML, CSS and Bootstrap as frontend. I used PostgreSQL database for this project. To understand the whole process of a web application, one must know about the database is necessary, and so we will have a glance over the PostgreSQL database. This is the UI of PostgreSQL database, and for this project I created a database called REST. It is here. If I expand this, you will have a schema here. In this schema, you will have the tables. If I expand the tables, you will have, we have a total for 13 tables in that. These are inbuilt models, and I have created three models for this. I created the three tables for this project. The first one is category. And if I view data, we have two categories. First one is Indian cuisine and second one is Italian cuisine. And the second one is food type. And in that we have two types, and the first one is sweet and second one is spicy. And if we go to menu table, we will be having four different tables, four different columns: first one name, price and category, and food type. So we will run the server now. I will run the server by typing Python manager to the run server. The server has started now. I will go to Google, type HTTP, and this is the UI of the web application called Restaurant. And this is the navigation bar, and it has a search option. Here it is showing hi guest because user is not logged in. Once the user is logged in, it will show his username, and it is showing for login and register as he is not logged in. And this is the Django filter. I will get back to this within few minutes. And this is the category which is getting fetched from the database, and these are the menu items. Then this is getting fetched from the database. And if I go to Indian cuisine, it will list all the items which belongs to Indian cuisine. And if I go to Italian cuisine, it will list all the products which belongs to Italian cuisine. Now I will go to register and register a member called the Django. Email will be santosh@gmail.com, password. I register and it is showing account successfully created for Santosh, and I will log in now. Santosh and his password. And I logged in, and here it is showing hi Santosh. And instead of showing the logout and the register, it is now, as he is logged in, it is showing as logout. And as I mentioned earlier, this is done using Django filters, and we can filter the data by passing the values to these fields. And this is a category field, food field, and a price range field. And here it is showing the items for all the category. Now if I pass Indian cuisine and hit search, it will show only for the Indian cuisine, the products which belong to Indian cuisine. And if I select Italian cuisine, yeah, it will show the products which belongs to Indian cuisine. And if I select Indian in that put type sweet, it will select Indian cuisine and also belongs to sweet. And if I select spicy, it will check for Indian cuisine and spicy. And if I don't want anything, it will list all the cuisines item. And if I go for Italian and spicy, It will show the result for every following. And if I don't, if I select sweet, there is no product which belongs to category in Italian cuisine and has a food type of sweet. If I don't pass anything, it will list the product item which is there in the Italian cuisine, and if I don't select anything, it will list all the products. This is the price range field. We can filter the data by passing the price. Like now, idli comes for 40, pizza 120, and dosa is for 60. And if I pass 15, only I should get idli. If I pass 15, I'm getting idli only. If I pass 70, it will show all the menu items which are below 70. And if I pass 150, it will also include no pizza. And if I pass 110, it will list all the products which comes below 110 rupees. And if I mention nothing, it will show all the products. And what if I want a menu which belongs to Indian cuisine, and the price of that menu should be less than 50. If I hit search, it will list the product which is there in Indian cuisine and which has a price range less than or equal to 50. And if I go to Italian cuisine, we have no products less than 50 rupees in Italian cuisine. If I go to Indian and I search for 70, I will get both the menu items. And if I don't select anything also, I will get the menu items which are there less than 70 rupees. Yeah, let me clear this first. Yes, it is showing all the menu items now. And this is the search bar. We can get the particular menu item by passing its name. Here I will search for idli and hit the search. It is showing the results for idli. And if I go for dosa, it is showing dosa. And if I go for pizza, it is showing the pizza. And if I don't pass anything, it will list all the menu items here. And if I log out, it will redirect to the login page. If I click on log out, it will redirect to the login page. Okay. And now I logged out. It is showing hi guest and login. It is asking me for the login and a register. And this web application has a browser compatibility. Now we have seen its performance in Google Chrome. Let's see how it looks in different browsers. This is Mozilla Firefox. I search for and hit enter. This is how it looks in Mozilla Firefox. And if I go to Internet Explorer and hit enter, this is how it looks in Mozilla Firefox. And all working will be the same. And the best thing is it has responsive. If I go to inspect, and this is the mobile view. This is how it looks in mobile. This is a responsive totally. And if I click on it, it will show like this. This is a mobile view, and this is the desktop view. And that's it. Thank you.